Today I wanted to talk to you about how I wrote a book from a simple Google Doc. That's right, I opened up a simple Google Doc for free, started typing in it, and ended up with a published book. So if you look at this book, it's relatively short. It's a real print book that you can buy on Amazon right now. It's about 40 something pages. It's almost more like a pamphlet than a book. And you can buy this on Kindle, Amazon, anywhere, and it has an ISBN number, as you can see right here. It's, in fact, a real book. And here's the cool thing. If I find a spelling mistake or a grammar error or just want to change around the book, guess what? I can go to Amazon and just tell it to make that change, and the next person that buys this book will see that change. So this book kind of reminds me of what a blog post is. If I write a blog post, I can go update it at any time. Similarly, with this book, I can go update it anytime. The reason I wanted to do this 100% from a Google Doc was because I wanted to write a book with the least amount of friction possible. So normally when you think about writing a book, you have to get a publisher, you have to get an editor, you have to get a book cover designer, you have to get all these different things in place and make it perfect. And then you publish it once and it stays like that forever. And that's a lot of pressure. So I was like, how can we just take the pressure out of this process? So the first book I did was called This Book Will Teach You How to Write Better. And it was a simple book explaining my thesis on how to write better in general with actual tactics and everything. And if you notice, it's super duper short. Once again, almost like a pamphlet more than a book. And the reason I did this was because I wanted someone to be able to sit down and within 15 to 30 minutes, understand all the information in this book and smack it into their head. I did not want a very long book because I personally don't like super long books that could be much shorter. So the goal for this book was to make it really easy to publish, and not so much about the book, but rather get better at the publishing process so I could put out more of these books without much friction. And I'm gonna tell you what I learned. First of all, the book cover. This is something that people stress out about a lot from the beginning, even though you probably should just make it at the end. Well, here's my book cover, and guess what? This was made inside of a Google Doc in Google Drawings. I'll show it to you right now. All I did was open up a Google Drawing within a Google Doc and started just outlining this book cover. Now, originally I meant for it to be a much more fancy cover, but I made this cover just kind of as a goof real quick and kind of ended up liking it. So every time I opened up my little doc, I saw this book cover and I was kind of like, that's it. Like, I like that book cover. Let's go with that. So the actual hardest part of making this book was not the technical aspect. Like I said, it was all made in a Google Doc. It was actually coming up with the idea for the book, right? That's actually a surprisingly hard thing to do when you actually think about it. So for the longest time, I had this idea called the death calculator that I made years and years ago. And the concept was formulated around middle school, high school, and college, where I was going to kill myself at 85 years old. Now, don't worry, that's not some sort of death wish or anything, but it's a concept I developed to plan out my life better. So as you can see from the back of this book, it says start, middle, end. Now, what I would tell people is that it's hard to plan out your life if you don't know when the end of it is. So if you go to Paris for 2 days, you'll probably pack everything you can to that trip. Go to the Eiffel Tower, get a beignet, go to the Louvre. But if you had 2 months to do Paris, meaning you had a much longer time frame for that trip, the trip would be much different. Maybe you go out to the French countryside, maybe you'd spend more time here or there. The point is, the only difference in those trips is that you had more time. So similarly with life, when I was trying to plan out my life, I had to know an end date. So my end date is 85 years old. Now, anytime I tell someone this concept, because I've thought about it so much, it makes sense in my head, then I would tell them, I'm like, in casual passing, I'd be like, yeah, I'm gonna end my life at 85 years old. And they'd be like, whoa, 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 Neville, what did you just say? You're gonna kill yourself at 85 years old? I'm like, yeah, of course. And so I wanted this book to be about that concept. And so that was actually the hardest part in coming up with the book, because I've already done a book about writing. So I was kind of like, do I want to do like just another one? It didn't really excite me. But this concept was one of those things in conversation that people were like, wait, what? And they'd always want to hear more about. So I thought maybe that would make a good book. The other hard part about making a book is actually kind of outlining the chapters. So originally I thought I would just outline the chapters real quick, and I did. I wrote them out, and I started filling them out. The problem was a lot of the chapters kind of overlapped. So I had three chapters in there about why it's good to plan the end of your life. And they all said the exact same thing. So kind of the hard part was going through and eliminating a lot of that redundancy and just combining all that stuff. So originally I thought I had like 15, 16, 17 chapters in this book. It ended up being about 10. One strategy I used throughout both of these books to write them was I would outline the chapters and then just fill in each chapter. So for example, in this book, one of the chapters is good life or long life. And I would just go and fill in my thoughts about good life or long life. The problem was a lot of times these thoughts were very scattered and I realized I kind of just didn't really have a point on the chapter. So you either have to formulate a good point and make it coherent or you have to just eliminate it altogether. So actually writing the book was not hard, but making it flow together, making good points, that part is difficult. So here's all the chapters of the book. So what I did was once I started getting a more clear idea of what I wanted this to be about, I wrote out all the chapters and filled in each one. Then what I did at the end was I tried to go make them flow together. So in fact, I actually moved some of the ones at the end to the beginning. And I moved some of the ones at the beginning to the end. So I just had to make the book flow together. And that process was, it did take some brain power. That part was kind of hard. The other cool thing about making something in Google Docs is that you can make images inside of it. So I actually have a bunch of images in the book, kind of like this, like charts. And the cool thing is, these were all made directly inside of the doc. I decided I did not really want to use a bunch of extra software, even though I know Photoshop pretty well, to use it and then pull it in. In fact, I was like, let me just make this 100% from a Google Doc and practice doing that. So the next time I write a book, I could also write it right within a Google Doc just for simplicity's sake. And another cool thing I learned was that you can actually embed tables and stuff. So one of the big parts of this book was going to be, I was compiling all this information about when people normally die. And so I was worried that that would not come out very well in a book, but surprisingly it did. Look at this. Here's a bunch of tables that I have in the book and they came out absolutely great. So as you can see, so far the writing of these two books that I did was really, really simple on a technical level. The actual hard parts were all in the writing. But one technical thing that I did find a little bit difficult was the formatting of the books. So you know how like a book page will end right here and then start right here? That is relatively easy with page breaks inside of Google Docs, but the problem is getting everything looking exactly like you want on Kindle and print. It's a little bit of a fussy process. And for that, I went to Fiverr. That's right, the site where you can just get little gigs done. I hired one guy to do the print version of the book, so this one, and one guy to do the Kindle version of the book. Honestly, I think the Kindle version of the book is super easy because you literally just submit the Google Doc and that's about it. But for the print book, you have to make the digital turn into physical. So that's always a little bit of a problem. So literally for about 10 bucks, I got someone to format this entire book correctly and they did it right the very first time. All I had to do for that was I sent the Google Doc over to the Fiverr person and I downloaded it as a docx, meaning a Word document for them. And then they went and made the correct Word document and PDF for me to upload for print format. And the person who did the Kindle uploaded it to a file called EPUB that you upload to the Kindle platform. And then that was it. That was literally the whole process. I was really satisfied that I was able to make this entire book, including the cover and back and inside, 100% in Google Docs. And the reason that excites me is because I write online so much that a lot of my stuff just ends up living in blog posts. Whereas whenever this is printed out, there's some, I don't know, cool visceral feeling you get that you made this thing. Even though this book probably took about the same amount of work as a long blog post, it still gives me far more pride to just see the thing in print and have like a collection of things I've wrote that can last the test of time. So hopefully this inspires you to make a book. All you have to do is go to docs.google.com and start typing and making images right within that Google Doc. And you can eventually just publish it to Kindle or print through kdp.amazon.com. All the things I've listed here so far have been free. There's really no cost associated with them. So you can publish a book essentially for free. You can actually make money from a book. In fact, this book still sells copies. I don't really promote it or anything, and it still sells copies every month, and I make like a decent little income off of it. And imagine if you had a whole host of those books, what kind of income that could possibly generate. And a cool thing about books that my friend Ryan Holiday, like a bazillion time best-selling author, has talked about is whenever you release one book, and all your other books end up selling well too during that launch. And then if you release another book, all those other books sell even better. So it has this kind of weird compounding effect as you release more and more books. Anyways, I hope this inspires you to make a book if you want to, and realize that it's much easier than it seems, unless you want to go the whole publisher route and do that, which is awesome too. But if you want to make a quick and dirty book, or just get your hands dirty and try it out and see what happens, you could totally publish your own book for free with all free tools. So if you want to check out this book, it's called You're Gonna Die, and it's A Framework for Happiness by Neville Medora. And you can buy this on Amazon for Kindle or print right now. And my previous book was more about writing and copywriting, and it's called This Book Will Teach You How to Write Better. You'd also buy that on Kindle and print. My name is Neville Medora, and I will talk to you later.